Good morning and welcome. Patriot Radio News Hour. I'm Joe Jaquint, CEO of the Patriot Trading Group, and happy Friday. We've made it through another week. Give yourself a round of applause, but don't worry. No rest for the weary here. I got a lot of stuff going on here at the KHNC studios. I just want to update you. So it is possible that we may go down for a brief moment here or there. We are having the transmitter worked on. We are also, today is conversion day. Today we are flipping the switch from the old operating system to the new operating system. And well, it should go perfectly. We all know that there's going to be a few hiccups in it, but we're making the big move today. So if you hear any issues, we're working on it. We're working on it, but we're hopeful that if nothing else, we'll have something playing at all times. But we'll be working all through the weekend to work out any of the bugs. Once we're done, it's going to be fantastic. So bear with us. It's been obviously a big week this week. And yesterday I met with the Green Herb, with Tom and Linda, and wow, they're just fantastic. And I know they've had some issues. I got some good news to report on that front. They should be getting products back in the next 6 weeks. So stay tuned for that, and we'll give you updates as we go. But I will say this, Linda did the blood test for me yesterday, and it was really amazing. She is absolutely a home run hitter. She is fantastic at what she does. And I don't care if you just maybe you want to, you know, get in better shape, lose some weight, or you have something going on, you haven't been feeling well, or the doctors haven't been able to help you. It doesn't matter if it's a big problem, a little problem. A lot of the answers can simply be found by going in there and having her check out what's floating around in your bloodstream. I highly recommend them. But good news for them, they've got product coming. Should be about 6 weeks, and they'll have those shelves restocked up. Our toll-free number, 800-951-0592. The website at allamericangold.com, and so many things happened today. We had a ton of economic data out today. Right now, everything's down. Dow's down almost 300. The S&P's down over 20. The Nasdaq's down 50. Gold's down $8. Oil's down a dollar. Silver's down 18 cents. I mean, you name it, everything's down today, and we had issues in China. We had issues here at home. We had retail sales. We had so much to talk about. We'll try to get them all. But before I do, I had several customers come in over the last few days. And I know the other day I was making fun of you guys. Always want me to come up. Nobody was coming in the first day I was here, the second day I was here, and I only got one gift. So everybody over the last few days has been bringing me gifts. I appreciate the coolest one had to be from Steve. He had brought in, and I'll tell you this, I'd never seen it before. It's a vial, and in the vial is an ounce of silver. And it's just like silver shot, if you will. It's just little pieces of silver in this vial that makes up an ounce. And it has a label on it, and it's all faded out. Steve actually brought in a magnifying glass so I could actually read what was on the label. And what it was is it goes all the way back to 1968. If you know your history in silver, you know, we had silver coinage, you know, the pre-1965 junk silver, right? The half dollars, the quarters, the dimes. Well, we sell it all the time. Well, from 19, why we say pre-65? is because after 1964, the government took a lot of silver out of the coins. It went from 90% silver to 40% silver. So 1965, 66, 67, 68, those coins, those half dollars, quarters, dimes, they have silver in it, right? But it's only 40%, so it's a lot less, but there's still silver in it. But starting in 1969, the government was getting rid of having silver, any silver in the coins. And also at the same time, the government, we used to create silver certificates. Remember, like they looked like Federal Reserve notes. But instead, they were silver certificates saying, hey, this certificate is worth a dollar and is interchangeable with an ounce of silver. And they made silver certificates from 1878 all the way to 1964. When they knew they were getting rid of silver in the money, they gave you about a year to take any silver certificates that you had, and you could bring them in to an assay office and exchange it for one of these vials that contained an ounce of silver. And once after 1960, after the date passed, they said, that's it. I'll finish that story. I'll tell you what the silver certificate's worth today and what the ounce of silver's worth today, too, when we get back. Take the Radio News Hour. I know it's Friday, but we got Fake News Friday, but I wanted to finish this, and then we'll get to it. So Steve brought in just the coolest gift. And from June 24th, 1967 to June 24th, 1968, you could trade your silver certificate for raw silver bullion, which came in these little vials. After that, you couldn't do it anymore. So you had 1 year to turn them in. Here's the thing. So silver today, $14.50, $14.75 an ounce. Those silver certificates, if you didn't turn them in, places will sell them for like $2, right? We always do it every once in a while. I haven't done it in a while, and I probably should. I'll do it again. I'll have to go get some. We usually just throw them in every once in a while. So they're pretty much a novelty, right? You go buy them somewhere. Grandpa's Pawn's got some, and I think they're $2. Much better, obviously, having the ounce of silver worth $14.75, a much better deal. But again, just shows you how worthless everything really has become. And I want to thank everybody that's come in. I will tell you, I will be leaving today at 2:00. So it's going to take me a little. I got to drive to the airport, return the car. So at 2:00. So if you want to stop by and say hello, you have to be here before 2:00 if you want to catch me. Now, Ramon, let's hit Fake News Friday.
One of these things is not like the others. One of these things doesn't belong. Can you tell which thing is not like the others before I finish my song?
From News Headquarters, this is
Fake News Friday.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I please have your attention? I've just been handed an urgent and horrifying news story. And I need all of you to stop what you're doing and listen.
What is real? How do you define real?
Fake News Friday.
Fake.
Welcome back, Fake News Friday. This is the episode where all of these stories that we're going to do are actually true, which in itself should be horrifying, because if you really listen, you're like, that can't be true. Nope, they're all true, except in one of them, our buddy Glenn, the professor, changes a detail, and between Jason, Brian, and I, right, we got to pick out which one's fake. I haven't seen Brian, so, Jason, does that mean you're playing today?
I'm the one playing, and I'm going to do a Joe Namath sort of thing. I guarantee I'm going to come out on top today.
Well, you know what I think it is Brian fell back, because Brian's been whooping my butt, and you're like the perennial loser. Right, you're like the old New Orleans Saints where they used to put the bag on their head, right, because they were so bad.
Not today, though, not today.
All right, let's see. Ramon, you ready? Let's go.
Let's go. California officially became the first state in the nation on Wednesday to require homes to build in 2020 and later to be solar-powered. Energy officials estimate the provisions will add $10,000 to the cost of building a single-family home. That's story number one. Story number two, in a national study of almost 10,000 high school students and 500 teachers, 89% of high school students agree that people should be allowed to express unpopular opinions, and almost half of the high school students and teachers say they have not much or no trust at all in media to report the news accurately and fairly. That's story number two. Story number three, Iran has made the decision to leave OPEC by January next year. The Iranian oil minister said Wednesday that due to increasing sanctions placed on his country, they had no choice but to leave OPEC and sell their oil for gold or any other currency other than the U.S. dollar on the open market. That is story number three. Joe, would you like to go first, because you're the man in charge?
Absolutely not.
I'll go first. I'm guessing it's number one, and I don't have any particular reason, but I was listening to those other two stories, and the first one really seemed fake. I just have a strong feeling. I'll go off my instinct.
All right.
You're going to go with number one.
Number one.
Which was the California solar power thing.
Yes.
Here, you know, I feel like we're at a disadvantage. We've been so busy doing other stuff. We aren't even really knowing what's in the news. But since Jason went with number one, I know it can't be that.
Okay.
So what was the second one again?
It was high school students and teachers actually don't believe the media that much to trust that they will tell
right.
the story
and,
correctly.
And then Iran leaving OPEC was the third one.
Correct.
I'm going to go with Iran leaving OPEC as the fake story.
All right. And the winner for round one is, in fact, Joe. Yes.
You all, listen, if anything bad happens, and we got a lot of stuff going on today, I promise you it is Jason's fault. How about that? See, Brian's gone, and I'm back to doing what I do best, winning.
Now, I might agree with that, Joe. So Ramon, I'm going to actually concede victory to Joe right now. I have can you play that X-Files music?
Here it is.
All right, I got something for Joe today. I want to test Joe out for a moment. I was listening to November when Brian was pummeling Joe week after week, and Joe just couldn't figure out what was going on. Wasn't actually keeping count that Brian was 8 for 8 on all the stories. I started thinking, man, maybe someone's given Brian the answers.
What?
I was wondering, and then I come in today and I decide, well, let's just give. I'll throw Joe a bone and give it to him. But if that's true, Joe, is that fake news?
I'm going to tell you right now. That would make sense. But you know what? Here's the sad part about it. I don't even know that I got any of them right.
You got quite a few of them right over the weeks. I conspired with Glenn and Brian, and our customers were coming in and feeling so bad for me. And they told me I needed to stand up to Joe, and so I was like, you know what?
You guys cheated me.
We're just gonna let Joe just scratch his head and for a whole month of November, Joe just
you let Brian kick my back. Really?
Yeah, it was the whole month of November, Brian was giving all the answers.
Man, I thought Brian was the smartest guy out there. And a couple of times I was losing, and I had to go with a different answer to try to pull off a win.
You were doing gamesmanship, and Brian was just...
Oh, man.
Joe, I want to let you...
Wait a minute, Ramon, did you know this?
I did not know this. I am completely...
conspiracy!
I had nothing to do with it.
Brian and Glenn were shaking. They were so scared. Don't do this to Joe. I don't know what he's going to do. And I'm like, oh, come on.
I'm getting ready to cancel Fake News Friday forever.
You know what you should do, Joe? Just turn in the radio station and say, you know what? I'm not going to buy it now. That's it.
Yeah, that's it. It's over.
That's what Glenn's afraid of. But as we had spoken a couple weeks ago, we're going to do a couple changes anyways. And we will never, ever cheat Fake News Friday.
You know what?
Now
I can't believe it. You know, obviously, you know what? Let's put it this way. If I lose, we know that they were up to something. The fact that the three of you were smart enough to pull this off shocks me.
Yeah.
But I don't know. What are you guys doing up there?
Brian's on. He has a comment. He's not in the office yet.
Oh, Brian wants to say something. I want to hear it.
Go for it, Brian.
Joe, this is all Jason's doing, but I do have to claim a couple credits. I won the tiebreakers because Ramon kind of threw a curveball a couple of times there. So I have to at least claim a couple of tiebreakers that were on my own.
Now, let me say this. You deliberately cheated to unseat me, and you did this on Jason's behalf? I want to know who the ringleader was. That's who I want to know. Heads are going to roll. I want to know who did it.
That was me.
Can you blame it on Brooke?
You know what? I'm going to tell you right now. I hope Brooke's listening, because is this what you're going to teach your son? By the way, I had dinner over at Jason's house last night. Oh, yeah. He's so nice to me, right? Oh, yeah. Come on and have a home-cooked meal and just hang out and let's chit-chat. No mention of how he was cheating me.
Well, I thought we would just give an example to the audience of how the Federal Reserve actually works. You know, it's just it's kind of a teaching thing.
Oh, I see. You're educating everybody.
Educating.
Wow.
And we had to take get one of Glenn's guns away and literally point it at him to get him to go along with it.
Well, I was going to say, I would believe that of the three of you, Glenn by far has the most integrity, obviously.
But he had to give us the answers.
That's true.
Hey, wait a minute.
Remote, are you sure you didn't?
Listen, I either have the most integrity or I'm the dumbest person on this program. One of the two.
Well, obviously, you'd have to beat me for that because these guys were cheating and it never even crossed my mind.
And you had dinner with them, too.
You didn't trust Ramon to not spill the beans.
Yeah, yeah, you brought me into the nest, made me feel part of the family while you were screwing me the whole time.
Well, Joe, last Friday when you were still in Arizona, we were going to do it then, but then you had the appointment, so we had to put it off.
Oh, I see. So you let it go a whole nother week.
Supported Jason.
Bernice, you better calm down over there. You supporting that kind of behavior.
She raised the son like that.
Yes. But anyway, so let's just say this. I am back to winning when we play by the rules.
Yeah, you will be.
Brian, I'm extremely disappointed in you. I thought if anybody... Jason, I expect it from him, right? I mean, he's getting clobbered week after week. But for you to say to go along with, I'm disappointed. I really am.
The whole reason for it, Joe, is that we just wanted to stop the gloating just for a few minutes, just a few weeks.
This was the favorite part of my day.
And to see the suffering was just
it was horrible. Life. I was taking these beatings. I was upset. I wanted to cancel Fake News Friday. Wow.
We had to pop a large bubble of puffery that was going on.
There was a lot of puffery, man. All right. Anyway, there you go.
I know that the partners have some backbone, by the way.
Yes, yes. You guys, there you go. All right. Maybe I deserved it. I was a little rough on Jason. So there you go. So all is right in the world. And the only reason why they won is they were cheating. So
Scouts honor will not happen again.
Not at all. Scouts. All right. Well, you know, I don't know if you guys saw the Scouts are getting ready to file for bankruptcy. Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah. So, 800-951-0592. You never know what we're going to do or say. And I'm thrown for a loop right now. You guys are leaving me speechless. The conspiracy theories, they're everywhere. And even right here at Patriot Training Group, you're going to get them. When we get back from the break, Chicago, Chi-Town, saying, we got a problem. We don't have any money for our pension system. I'm going to tell you what they're going to try to do to fix them. And then we're going to get into retail sales, Costco, and last but not least, what did Johnson & Johnson do? How long did they do it for? And how long did they know they were doing that? All of that and maybe a little more when we return. Patriot Radio News Hour, live from the KHNC studios, getting ready. This is a big day for us. We got conversions and crossovers, so bear with us, Colorado. But hopefully, by this time next week, things are going to be sounding excellent. We'll be back right after the break.
This is the Phyllis Schlafly Report, a daily broadcast from Phyllis Schlafly Eagles. And we're upholding the legacy of Phyllis Schlafly, grassroots activist, author of 27 books, and articulate voice for traditional values for more than 70 years. And now, from the archives of Phyllis Schlafly Eagles, here is Phyllis Schlafly.
Today, December 14th, is the anniversary of George Washington's death in 1799. He caught a chill riding horseback for several hours in the snow while inspecting his Mount Vernon farm. The next morning, it developed into acute laryngitis, and the doctors were called in. The common medical practice in those days was to bleed the patient in order to supposedly get rid of the so-called bad blood. So the doctor's response to Washington's illness was to cut his arm and bleed him heavily four times. Of course, we now know that was the worst thing the doctors could have done. George Washington died at the age of 67. Washington said, "Doctor, I die hard, but I am not afraid to go. I should have been glad, had it pleased God, to die a little easier, but I doubt not it is for my good." Washington's last words were, "Father of mercies, take me unto thyself." The early biographers of George Washington all assumed that he was unequivocally a Christian. He was a practicing Anglican and regularly recited the Apostles and the Nicene Creeds. Biographer Henry Cabot Lodge wrote that Washington referred to Jesus Christ as the divine author of our religion. Washington's public statements and private letters are full of Christian references. Here's an example. In a general order to his troops, dated May 2, 1778, Washington wrote, "To the distinguished character of patriot, it should be our highest glory to add the more distinguished character of Christian." Washington's tomb at Mount Vernon is engraved with the words, "I am the resurrection and the life, saith the Lord. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die."
This has been the Phyllis Schlafly Report from Phyllis Schlafly Eagles. Whether it's the vision of our founding fathers, the courage of our veterans, the moral compass of Christopher Columbus, or the fortitude of presidents like Lincoln and Reagan, the truth of history should not be undercut by liberal ideology. At Phyllis Schlafly Eagles, we honor history even as we look to the future. Join us at phyllisschlafly.com. That's phyllisschlafly.com.
Chicago, Chicago, that toddling town. Chicago, Chicago, I will show you around. I love it that you...
Welcome back, Patriot Radio News Hour, 800-951-0592. Talking about Chi-Town, you know, my oldest son plays football in college up there. And, by the way, shout out to my younger son who last night got named, to the second team, all academic team for Arizona, in the 5A. So, shout out to him and You know, he's getting it done on the field and in the classroom. But Chicago, we make fun of Chicago. We make fun of Illinois. And I guess when you think about it, Arizona and Colorado, we can, not that, that we're great, but we can always do the, hey, we're better than those guys. So Chicago, it seems like now every 6 months or so, they have to admit, it's getting worse, right? And I know that we said that it'd only be this bad, but it's actually even worse than that. Well, Ron Emanuel was out delivering a speech on how they are going to address the pension issue at the Chicago City Council meeting. The mayor came out with his great new plan. He said that the truth is, see, first plan one, tell the truth, right? So he goes for the truth card at the Chicago City Council meeting, that going back decades, too many elected officials, labor leaders, and civic leaders, people in positions of responsibility, agreed to a funding and benefit system that was not sustainable and therefore not responsible. Some knew it. Others should have known it. Now, if you're really telling the truth, you all knew it. Simply put, leaders in the past, see, not me, no. It was those other guys. Leaders in the past made commitments without resources to back them up. And now, inevitably, the bill has come due. His solution, he had a four-part program of how they were going to fix the pension problem in Chicago. First up, weed. That's right. That's right. Hey, when you're broke enough, you'll legalize weed. So the first thing they're going for is weed, right? They want to legalize weed, I guess, in the city of Chicago. I don't know. I he's only the mayor of Chicago. My guess is the rest of Illinois will go right along with it. So they're going to legalize marijuana, tax it. The problem is that's nowhere close to enough revenue. So then the mayor said, we are going to start adding casinos to the city of Chicago. And obviously, right, we're going to tax that as well. Unfortunately for everybody in Chicago, that's not going to be enough. So after you've hit the weed, you've got the casinos, they're going to eliminate the COLAs from the pensions. So the cost of living adjustments will no longer be honored. Unfortunately, that's still nowhere enough. The last part of the brilliant plan is Chicago wants to sell bonds. In other words, they are going to shift the pension problem to the taxpayer. So they're going to sell these bonds. They're going to give the proceeds to the pension funds and then stick the taxpayers with the bill. Because obviously now the city of Chicago will have to make the bond payment. And of course, if they default on the bond payment, then it goes back to the taxpayers to make the bondholders whole, if you will. So there, just so you know, when you know what's coming, and it really, like I said, it really doesn't matter. This is Chicago we're talking about. I mean, we're not talking about, some rinky-dink city. You know, we're not talking about Reno. We're not talking about even a city like Syracuse, New York, or Rochester. You know, we're not talking about Sedona or Flagstaff, right? We're not talking about Longmont or Greeley. Washington. It's not the weed. It's not the gambling, right? I remember years ago I was telling you, listen, they're going to legalize all this stuff. Not because they want to, because they need the money. But this is what I think is the real sad part in all of this. They're going to make the citizens of Chicago hold the bag. And remember, this is coming everywhere, right? Because you know the state of Illinois will follow, and then California and New York and Kentucky and Massachusetts, and it'll spread like wildfire, where all of a sudden the citizenry is going to be on the hook for all the male feces in government. And you think about, you know, all of the founding fathers and all of this. This is the problem with huge government. And it's got to change. We've got to go back to where our founding fathers wanted this to be, with limited government and sound money. And really, in his little truth-telling, right, nowhere in there did they go out and blame the people lending all of the money. Nowhere did you hear, because let's face it, why did they promise all this stuff? Do you know why? Because really, what got them into trouble? Well, we made these promises, and we weren't able to actually afford them. Why not? Because somebody told you that you could, right? And of course, that was what? That was the bankers. The bankers and their buddies on Wall Street, decades ago, went to the cities, went to the states, said, oh, no, you can afford this. Just give us the money. We'll manage it for you. We'll put you in the stock market, and you'll all be rich. Take the Radio News Hour. We'll be back right after the break. 800-951-0592. I don't know what's happened. I don't know how long it will last, if it's going to continue. But gold is rebounded. All of a sudden here, gold now, which was down $8-$9 earlier in the day, right now is down $2. Silver, which got down to just below 1450, is now 1460. The Dow is now down over 400 points. Just bad news all over the place. Retail sales came out here. They were actually okay, seasonally adjusted. As soon as you looked at the numbers unseasonally adjusted, retail sales were actually down year over year. But seasonally adjusted, they were up 0.2%. And that was kind of, you know, that was good news. But again, global warnings. China had bad numbers out again. The Dow's down now over 400 points as they're, you know, again, this is just where we're headed. We were able to, because of the tax cuts, survive it. The other big news today, Johnson & Johnson. Apparently, you know, I'll use the green herb as a great example, because the FDA kind of went after them, and I don't need to go into all the details, but it was pretty frivolous, okay? Just to put it bluntly, it probably really, when you hear about it, if you knew about it, it should have been a slap on the wrist at best. But Johnson & Johnson today, this is coming out of Reuters, apparently knew that their baby powders and their talc powders contained asbestos. And they knew it since 1957 and didn't tell anybody. Matter of fact, Johnson & Johnson spent decades lobbying Washington and the FDA not to check out their stuff. Oh, no, you don't have to put rules about asbestos on talc, because, you know, we got it handled. And apparently, Johnson & Johnson had to finally, through the court system, had to release internal documents which disclosed that the company since the 50s knew that their talc and baby powders contained asbestos, and they're being sued by, I think I don't know the exact numbers. I know that this the case that made it happen. 22 plaintiffs got together and formed like a mini class action lawsuit, and were able to get them to disclose. In the past, Johnson & Johnson has been sued, I guess, for this asbestos thing a bunch of times in the past, but only by one person at a time, and they were able to get the court system to not allow them to have to disclose everything they knew. Even in this case, Johnson & Johnson was able to get the courts to say that thousands and thousands and thousands of their documents needed to be concealed, so they, that we, you can't know all the details about what they knew. But apparently, Reuters was some of the documents they were forced to release, and Reuters now is reporting that Johnson & Johnson knew for decades that their baby powders contained asbestos and did their best to try to make sure none of us knew. And I bring this up because this is the hypocrisy of big government, right? And all of these mega corporations. And I know we focus here financially. We focus on too big to fail. We focus on your wealth, right? And how the government targets all of your money, right? And we did the example this morning when Steve brought in his little silver shot, if you will, where this was in from 1967 to 1968, you had the option of turning in your silver certificates and getting an ounce of silver shot instead. And today, those silver certificates, really, they're not really worth, you know, it's a novelty, you know, $2. And a lot of them, like when I give them away for nothing. If you still had the silver shot, right, you got $14.50. I mean, this is just what they do. And, of course, Johnson & Johnson lobbying up there in Washington, knowing that they're killing you and putting all of this stuff in the... into our food and into our health care and beauty products. I mean, they're slowly poisoning us to death so they can make a few bucks. And it absolutely amazes me. But again, right, they control the media. So you don't sit there and there's no one, right? They're more concerned about Donald Trump and Russians and paying off of women than they are about them putting chemicals into our products that kill us. Incredible. 800-951-0592. In other news, Costco, one of the best retailers out there, right? Year after year, quarter after quarter, they actually missed today. Costco shares down over 6%, said that... that sales did not come in as expected, that there's more competition, more pressure. In other words, here's what they really said. Things are costing more, and we got to start charging more because our margins were hurt. Patriot Radio News Hour, final segment on a Friday, coming up. 800-951-0592. What a week. So much happening, so much going on. Wall Street now down, closing in on 500 points as Costco's having the worst day in a decade. Huge news out of Johnson & Johnson today. Not to mention economic data here. All right, it wasn't horrible. I mean, we did have bad manufacturing data, which kind of goes along with the slowdown retail. So it was okay, but more bad news out of China. China's slowed down significantly now. They had their first decline in car sales in 30 years in China. By the way, they did announce they're going to go back to the old tariffs on automobiles for 3 months. So they're going to go back to the old tariff on automobiles for 3 months. We'll see if that can lead some progress there. Obviously not helping the Dow at all today. The specials today, so we have the $20 gold pieces. Gold was down a bunch, and so I lowered the price. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to leave it there. So you know what? The rest of the day, Merry Christmas to everybody. Happy New Year. U.S. $20 libs, $12.90. We were running those five libs. Listen, there's 12 five libs left. As a matter of fact, the five libs should be here today. They should be in Phoenix today as well. There's 12 of them left. So I'll still honor that price, too, $3.50 for the AU 5 Lib, and I'll still give you the 5 dimes if you want to, but there's only 12. You can't order more than that on those. 800-951-0592, that is the toll-free number. Place your order, support us, support all the advertisers, support everybody that's on your radio stations, because that's the sports, the station that allows all the great messages to get out there and make sure, as we just so you know, for Colorado, today we are converting. I'm staring at these walls of wires because we've got the old system hooked up, the new system hooked up. We are going to be switching over today, so there is some potential for things to get a little cattywampus. But don't worry, we're on it, we're getting it fixed. And I did also notice, by the way, Benedict Arnold just showed up. I see Brian is here. If you missed Fake News Friday, all last month they let me believe that I was losing, only to find out that my partners conspired against me and they gave Brian the answers.
Well, now that you've experienced the full gamut of high hopes for us and then have those dashed away,
you know, and you were the high moral compass of the group.
Well, as Ramon said, I think he took the high road. He was not involved. Glenn is one step below that, but above.
Oh, you know what? I will say this, and I know Glenn's going to listen to it later, right? And they're trying to tell me how Glenn didn't want to do it. Glenn knew. Obviously, he did it. He's the one that had the answers. If Glenn was a true friend of mine, he would have gave Brian the wrong answer.
Very, very reluctantly. Glenn did it very, very reluctantly.
Well, you know what? Joke's on me. You know, the only thing I said, so I did tell them during the break, I said, you know, I'm happy about the effort that you guys put into that, but think about all the things you should have been doing while you were conspiring to cheat me out of my glory. 800-951-0592, Patriot Radio News Hour, the heart of the Front Range, KHNC, KXXT, Phoenix. Everybody, have a great weekend. God bless everybody. Be safe. We'll be back on Monday.